सो हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल. जस्ट लेट मी नो इफ माई ऑडियो वीडियो इज ऑल क्लियर. प्लीज गिव मी अ क्विक थम्स अप इफ माई ऑडियो वीडियो इज ऑल क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू. या सो वेलकम टू दिस नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ लेट्स क्रैक नीट पीजी विद मी डॉक्टर चेष्टा अग्रवाल. एंड आई विल बी टीचिंग यू द इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट इन डर्मेटोलॉजी. एंड टूडे वी हैव द 10 मस्ट नो इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. सो I request all of you to please be live in this today's session. Before starting the today's session, let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your NEET PG educator on an academy, and I've myself scored All India rank 261 in my entrance examination. Now you all are on the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG, and that is an academy. You can download the Unacademy learning app using the name the Unacademy learning app. Once you download it, you have to use the category that is NEET PG in your case. Once you choose your category, you will see that there are a lot of things available for free on the platform. These are the 34,000 questions in the form of quizzes or live test, as well as you have live special classes. So you have 34,000 questions and you have live special classes which is available on the platform. I request each and every one of you to please go ahead, download the Unacademy learning app and use the welcome code Dr. Cheshta YT. Use the welcome code Dr. Cheshta YT to avail this free stuff. Now if you like these free classes and if you want to have it, or if you want to buy the paid subscription, we have two things available. One is the plus and another is Iconic. Now what are the benefits of Plus and Iconic? The Plus will give you an access to Unacademy live classes, structured course, live test and unlimited access to the platform. The Iconic, in addition to Unacademy, give you the access to Prep Ladder. In Prep Ladder we have video lectures, question banks, rapid revision courses. And in addition to the Prep Ladder access and Unacademy, the Iconic gives you study planner, study material, expert guidelines, test analysis and personal guidance. This is the price list for Iconic. If you take it for 1 month, you will have around 3000 rupees per month, and using the referral code will give you additional 10% discount. For Plus, we have options of shorter subscriptions like 3 months, 6 months, and using it or taking it for a longer duration, the per month cost decreases. Please don't forget to use the Dr. Cheshta YT as a referral code here also. We are currently going on with the 3 plus 1 scheme, that if you buy a 3 month subscription, 1 month is free. And if you buy a 12 month subscription, 2 month is absolutely free. So I request all of you to go ahead with 12 plus 2 or 3 plus 1 offer. We also conduct regularly the NEET PG grand test. So I request everyone to please conduct, attend these free grand tests which occurs every week. Then we have NEET PG session batch course starting from 16th. Target batch course started on 16th, and we have the MBBS professional batch course where we will be teaching you everything in detail, keeping in mind the practical and Viva guidance, answer writing guidance and clinical integrated dual educator sessions. I request all my dear students to please be a part of it. Starting with the first instrument of the today's session, that is topical anesthesia. So what is the instruments or bedside procedures you do? So topical anesthesia, which includes the lignocaine, prilocaine, topical anesthesia is something which we use very, very frequently in a patient. Now in topical anesthesia, this will cause the loss of sensation of the whole thickness of your skin or whole thickness of your epidermis, dermis. And with this, you can do the minor procedures on the skin very, very easily. Now coming to the second procedure or second instrument, that is chemical peeling. Now what is chemical peeling? It is a procedure where you apply a chemical on the skin and this chemical will cause controlled destruction. I hope everybody knows that you have three layers of the skin: epidermis, dermis, and the lowermost is the fat cell layer, which is subcutaneous tissue. I hope everybody knows this, that you have dermis, epidermis, and the lowermost layer, that is the subcutaneous layer. Now what happens when you apply the chemical? It causes destruction. Depending upon the strength of the chemical, it causes destruction of these superficial layers. And when there is destruction of the superficial layer, the lower layers will have, the lower layer will regrow, and anything, any lesion, pigmentation or irregularity present in the superficial layers are gone. The new layer will come, the remodeled or regenerated. So if you can see in this image, you can see that the upper layers have many of the rough surface. You have clogged pores, you have irregular rough surface, you have presence of wrinkles, everything. But when you apply the chemical peel, the new skin which regrowth, it was absolutely fine compared to the previous one. And you can see that there is opening of the pores, there is no loss, or there is absolutely normal upper layer. So that is how the chemical peeling works. Now, chemical peelings are of three types. We have superficial peels, we have medium peels, and we have deep peels. Superficial peels means it only exfoliate up till the level of epidermis. And the example here are glycolic acid and salicylic acid. The medium peel, it exfoliates up till the papillary dermis. I hope you remember that if this is the skin block, the upper part is called as papillary dermis and the lower part is called as reticular dermis. I hope you remember this. The upper part is called as papillary dermis and the lower part is called as reticular dermis. So in medium peel, the depth of penetration or the exfoliation is up till the papillary dermis, while in deep peel, you can even reach up to the reticular dermis. Now, what are the different uses? First of all, dyschromias. So you can see that here the patient has brown pigment, which means epidermal pigment. If we do sequential chemical peeling, the superficial layers will go, okay? The superficial layers will go and you will see such a bright skin. The regrowth of the skin will do not have any pigmentation present in them. Second, acne. We have discussed that the clogged pores as well as the pigmentation associated with acne will improve very well with respect to the acne comedones. And third is presence of the fine wrinkles. Can you see these fine wrinkles? On sequential application of the chemical peels, the regrowth of the collagen is expected. So you can even have improvement in the fine wrinkles when you use chemical peeling. Coming to the third instrument, that is microderma aberration. Now, chemical peeling was doing a chemical derma aberration. It was removing the superficial layers with the help of chemicals. Microderma aberrator, they work on a very similar manner. But instead of using a chemical, we are using either the diamond probe or we are using the crystals. We are using the zinc oxide crystals for removing, or aluminum oxide crystals for removing the superficial damaged skin. And because of this, this process is called as micro resurfacing. Now you can, I'm very sorry for this. Yes. So what happens that in microderma aberration, you will use the same method, like if the superficial skins are very shallow, if the superficial skins are very irregular, you will use a derma probe. Can you see this is a probe? So in this probe, you can have the passage of the crystals, which is the aluminium crystal, or even you can have a diamond tip probe. So when you apply it manually on the skin, it causes micro resurfacing of the skin, and that is how it is called as microderma aberration. The uses are similar for the fine wrinklings, for acne comedones, and even for dyschromia, you can use microderma aberrations. Coming to the fourth procedure, that is microneedling. Now for microneedling, we use an instrument which is called as derma roller. For microneedling, we use an instrument which is called as derma roller. Please look at this instrument. This instrument consists of a handheld probe. And in the anterior part, you have a drum which consists of around 192 needles. The length of the needles depend. For example, it can vary from 0.5 mm to even 2 mm or 2.5 mm. Now, what do? We will rotate this derma roller over the skin. And while rotating the derma roller, it causes micro punctures. Can you see we are rotating? This is a derma pen. Here we are rolling it, and in derma pen we are doing a stamping method. So in both these manners, we are creating the micro channels in the skin, and these micro channels will stimulate the collagen present in the dermis and it causes resurfacing of the skin. So you look at this image, there is a deep scars here, but on stimulating it, you can see that the scar have filled a lot. So that is how the micro needling, which causes micro punctures in the skin, causes collagen induction, and that is why it is called as collagen induction therapy. Please remember, it is also called as collagen induction therapy, that is micro needling, used very well for the acne scars, even can be used for androgenic alopecia. You can use it here even in the patients of androgenic alopecia. On doing micro needling, you can stimulate the stem cells of the surrounding hairs and you can induce the hair growth. Coming to the next instrument, and that is cryotherapy. Please remember, cryotherapy is used for a lot of indications. For example, you have benign indications like viral lesions, skin tags, seborrheic keratosis. You have pre-malignant lesions like actinic keratosis, Bowen's disease, and malignant conditions like basal cell carcinoma. Now in cryotherapy, we have a cryo gun. And this cryo gun is filled with liquid nitrogen of minus 196 degree centigrade. Now what do you do? You will spray the liquid nitrogen on the recipient areas or on the affected areas, and you will allow it to warm up. So you will do this cooling and warming up 3 cycles of freeze and throw. And when you do this, it causes intracellular crystallization. And this intracellular crystal formation will cause its damage to the cell. And this is how the cryotherapy works. So please remember, cryotherapy, we have a cryo gun, we give around 3 freeze-thaw cycles, and following which there is intracellular crystallization causing damage to the underlying skin. Coming to the next instrument, that is comedone extractor. Now if you look at the instrument very very carefully, you just need to identify these instruments. Can you see? It has a cup shaped structure. It has a cup shaped structure. And in the center of the cup, you have a hole. So what happens if there is a comedone? You will use this instrument somewhat like this. This is how you will put the cup. And in the center of the cup, you have a hole. So when you press this cup like this, the material from the comedone will easily get accumulated inside the cup from the hole present in the center. And that is how it works on both open comedones and in closed comedones. In closed comedones, you may need to create a hole in the center of the closed lesions so that when you put this cup, the material will automatically come out. So very important, what is the comedone extractor used in? Next is the molluscum curette. Again, look at the instrument. You have a completely round ring shaped structure with a very sharp margins. Now again we'll do, or if suppose this is the molluscum lesion, you will put the ring around the lesion somewhat like this. You will put the lesion like this and you will give a tangential pressure. On giving the tangential pressure, this whole lesion will come out, and this is how you can create improvement in the lesion of molluscum curette or molluscum contagiosum. It works very well in molluscum contagiosum. Understood? Please do not get confused between the comedone extractor and molluscum curette, because they look very similar to each other. Next is skin biopsy punches. First look at this. The skin biopsy punches, they come in the variable diameter starting from 1.5 mm and we have larger up till 6 mm. Most frequently we use 1.5 and 2 mm if we are doing it for therapeutic for diagnostic purpose, but you can even use larger one for the therapeutic purpose, like for removal of epidermoid cyst or for the plunge grafting of vitiligo. Now how do you do this, or how do you use it? You will keep this probe perpendicular to the surface of the skin and you will give a rotatory movement. Can you see? You are giving a rotatory movement to it. On giving the rotatory movement, it simply dips in and you can remove the 3 mm, 4 mm, whatever the size punch, you can remove that mm thickness of the skin very, very easily and comfortably. So please remember, this is how the skin biopsy punch is used. You can use it for the therapeutic purpose in vitiligo, in epidermoid cyst, and diagnostic purpose where you have diagnostic confusion, where you are not able to make the diagnosis. The next is Wood's lamp. It is a bedside instrument for mainly the diagnostic purpose. Look at this instrument. It has a glass window. This is the place from where you will hold it, and this is the part from where you will put it to the electricity. There is a glass window which is present over this rectangular box, and just below this rectangular box you have the bulb which emits the UV radiation. Now this bulb emits the UV radiation, and there is a filter present in below it. So only the radiation of 365 nanometers will come out. So what is the wavelength emitted by the Wood's lamp? It is the 365 nanometer. And why? Because there is a filter which is present, which is made up of nickel oxide and barium silicate. Nickel oxide and barium silicate. So please remember, on the Wood's lamp you have a filter of nickel oxide and barium silicate. Next are the instruments of the nail surgery, which we use very frequently for ingrown toenail. Ingrown toenail, or also called as onychocryptosis. So normally the nail grows anteriorly like this, but in few cases, instead of growing anteriorly, it starts to grow laterally like this. And when it grows laterally, it causes a lot of pain in the patient. So what the instrument used for them are of two type. One is nail elevator. So with the help of this instrument, we separate the nail folds from the nail plate, and we elevate the nail plate from the nail bed. And with the help of the another instrument, this is called as nail cutter or nibbler. With the help of this nail cutter or nibbler, we will cut the additional nail which is growing laterally downwards. Now with this method, we are removing the extra nail, and after doing or removing the extra nail, we will cauterize the matrix cell, because these matrix cells are causing the abnormal growth. So only over that particular area you will cauterize the nail matrix area. Okay, so this is how the nail instrument are used. One is nail elevator. I'll write it down here. This is nail elevator, and another is nail cutter or nibbler. Nail cutter or nibbler. Understood? Lastly, we have Humby's knife. We have today only seen the this instrument in the today's session. So Humby's knife is used for the thin skin grafting in the patient of vitiligo. It takes thin skin graft. So you can see that the proper graft is this one. This is too thin and this is too thick. Only up till the pinpoint bleeding you have to take the graft in a patient of vitiligo from the Humby's knife. Then you have hair transplant instrument. You have hair punches. These are the hair punches. And these are the instrument which helps in improving. These are the forceps which helps in removing the hairs, the hair follicular unit, as well as it helps in inserting the hair follicular unit. So for example, look at this image. It tells you a characteristic feature. The first step in the hair transplant is, with the help of the hair punches, you will make the punch. So if you are using this instrument, you are creating the punch. The size varies from 0.7 to 0.9 mm. So we are creating the punches in the donor area, which is more frequently the posterior aspect of the scalp. Now once you create the punches, you will remove this punch with the help of the forceps. Now once we remove this punch, you will separate it, or you will keep the graft in the normal saline. And after that, with the help of the forceps, first you will create the slit over the recipient area, and you will put those grafts onto the slit which is created mainly over the recipient area, which is present on the anterior aspect. So this is a technique which is called as follicular unit extraction. where you are extracting the follicular unit. There is another technique which is called as follicular unit transfer, where we are removing the whole thickness of the posterior scalp. We are removing this whole part. I can show you with the help of a. We are removing this whole part. We are removing the skin. We are creating or we are removing the follicular units in the laboratory, and then we are reinserting it again over the donor areas. So that is how we have the hair transplant instrument work. Lastly, we have manual derma abrader. Please remember, if you are doing a vitiligo surgery, you have to create the recipient area fresh. And for creating the recipient area fresh, you will use a derma abrader. So with the help of derma abrader, you will make that area fresh. You will rub it onto the lesion until it will have pinpoint bleeding. And after that, you will put a graft so that the graft will be accepted very, very betterly. So with this, we are done with the today's session. We are done with the today's session of instruments in dermatology. If you like the today's session, please give me a quick thumbs up. Or you can give the thumbs up in the image or in the comment section below. Please subscribe to Unacademy Learning app. Use my referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. You can even subscribe to this YouTube channel, that is Let's Crack Neat PG. You can follow me on the Telegram, that is Let's Crack Neat PG is the name of the Telegram group. And please don't forget to hit the bell icon for the notification of all my classes.